Good afternoon and welcome to America's Home Cooking. I am making whole wheat pancakes with nuts in them this time. Maybe we should call them nutty whole wheat. All right, we need to beat one egg, and they recommend using an egg beater. They want you to beat this egg royally. In other words, beat it well. Buttermilk. Whoa, that's full of cultures. They want you to be careful. The next ingredients I'm going to put in another bowl and add it all at once. So this is going to make 16 4-inch pancakes also. I forgot to tell you that. All right, with flour, we need 1 1/4 cups of whole wheat. Add 1 teaspoon of sugar to this. 1 teaspoon, very much sugar. We need 1 teaspoon baking powder. Now, this is the one I made, and I know it's strong. And 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Salt, go over here, and let me see if I got everything except the shortening. Hold on. Where did I put my nuts?
They're right in front of me.
Now they want us to put, they recommend 1/4 cup of chopped nuts. Okay. So let me get my cutting board and knife, and we'll start chopping. The way they do, and you don't coat them with the flour, they don't hold together. This is why I do this. even for pancakes, muffins, or anything, I make sure that I coat them with a flour mixture. These rules, when you break them, things don't work out quite the way you want, so it's important. And I'm using walnuts, but it does not state what kind. If you're in the South, walnuts are more expensive than pecans, so I would recommend for you to use pecans, because that's what we used to use. Tablespoons of soft shortening. So I'm using this. Just using Crisco. There'll be plenty of butter and stuff on it soon enough. Sometimes instructions don't make sense. Well, better if I put flour into it. This, but I'm not using an egg beater because I've got nuts in this, and this is not going to work. That's why you have wide whisk like this, and then you have the fine ones. Hope you notice I didn't add any powdered milk.
I forgot.
I'll add it in now. It's not hard. Because it always breaks down. So we're going to add 2 tablespoons. When you do the dry ingredients, add 2 tablespoons of powdered milk. We don't need the wheat germ because we already have the wheat flour. So we can bypass it. Now see, this is a wide whisk, so if you have like fruit and stuff and you have to whisk it, you need the wide one. I'll show you the difference. You see how fine this one is? See the difference? They're wider. That's why I use the wider one, because the nuts and stuff. Sometimes you have something, you have chunks of apple in it, or nuts, or dried fruit and stuff, and you start to mix it, and they said whisk it, or mix it. That whisk really comes in handy. Now, because this is whole wheat, we have to be extremely careful because it will burn with the powdered milk.
maple syrup that didn't marmalade, so we're gonna put this on top of the pancakes. So I will have butter between each pancake. Be careful, whole wheat does burn much easier. Not quite yet. Okay. Now pancakes are funny. You cook them on a low flame and you'll see bubbles around the edges. That's not when it's ready to turn over. It's when the bubbles come up in the middle, it's time to flip it over. That means it's halfway cooked, because if you flip it too early, it'll be raw in the middle. So when they're ready to flip, I'll be back. Okay, it's time to flip them. Let me get this one on, and I took one off so I could show you why you cook it on low heat. This is how they should come out, the whole wheat, you see? So you have to be a little more patient with them than with the other pancakes. And you'll see them brown on the other side, and you flip them over. These you'll take off because I've already done one side. But I'll see you when I'm done. And here it is. I always serve some eggs with it and bacon with my pancakes, so I get that extra protein I'm looking for. Even though I put protein in the whole wheat, I always make sure there's added protein on it. Take care. Bye-bye.